First thing you need to do is to use your outer fabric and cut two pieces, which are 10 inches by 17 inches. Once you've cut your face fabric, you then need to cut a piece of your inner fabric, which is going to be the slots for your pens and pencils, and that also needs to be 10 by 17 inches. The first thing you need to do is to take the pocket piece and fold it in half with the raw edges towards you and iron along the fold. This is going to be your pocket piece. So once you've done this, you need to take one piece of your face fabric and lay the pocket piece flat at the bottom, lining up the bottom edges. So once you've lined all the edges up, you're going to pin along the side, all the way along the bottom, and then down the other side, and then we're going to stitch it. So the next thing you need to do is to mark out all the pockets for your pens and pencils. We're going to make them 1 inch wide, and then we're going to have two at either end, which will be 2 inches wide for any of the larger items. Now that we've marked all of the positions for our pockets, we're going to stitch all along all of the lines. Make sure you backstitch at the top of them to make sure that it's going to be nice and reinforced when you're putting your pens in and out. The next thing we're going to do is attach the final outer piece to the pocket piece, and we're also going to put the elastic in place. You can either use a small piece of flat elastic, rolled elastic, or if you have a small hair tie, that'll also work. So we're going to lay the right sides together of the fabric, aligning up all the edges. So if you're using cut elastic, make sure that the elastic sits on the inside of the fabric when you pin it in, so that when you turn the fabric inside out, it will be on the right hand side. Turn the pencil case right side out, press the edges, and then stitch all the way around to finish it off. Next, you need to attach the button to the outside of the pencil case. You can either use a button that you've got from a haberdashery store. We're using a covered button. We will link a tutorial for this in the description or above. Once you're ready to sew the button on, what you need to do is put the pens and pencils that you're going to be using into the pencil case and then roll it up so that you'll be able to see exactly where to stitch the button onto. So we're going to use a pen to mark that in a minute. And now you have your finished pencil case. Thanks for watching, we hope you enjoyed this one. We've got lots more makes on the website and on social media.